So there's this DJ Hero box for 10, Guitar Hero 15 for the PS2, and some controllers. I'm gonna make a play on this.
What's going on, guys, and welcome to today's video. We are going to hit 3 to 4 garage sales, and we are also going to check out a local antique mall, so you don't want to miss this.
Not another retro channel.
Clip, I went ahead and snagged this Super Soaker. It is the vintage one from 1990, and I got it for 40 cents and the Super 8 Blu-ray for only $1.
So there's this DJ Hero box for 10, Guitar Hero 15 for the PS2, and some controllers. I'm gonna make a play on this.
In that garage sale, I was able to pick up everything that you saw, the PS2, the PS2 controllers, the Guitar Hero controller, the DJ Hero 2 end box. I got that all for $30. These DVDs were only $1 a piece, so I went ahead and picked them up. But we're gonna take a look at everything that I got at the garage sales at the end of the video. But check out this footage from my local antique mall.
Okay, so our first booth, we have tons of starting lineups. As you can see, there's Ken Griffey Jr. We got, who is this? Oh, Derek Jeter. Minnie Dykstra. Tino Martinez. And then there's a ton of hockey ones over here in this corner. Then over here, there's bunch of NASCAR for days, and here's some plushies. We have some comic books over here, some horror comics. It's pretty sweet. Tomb of Dracula, though, $8, or is it $4? I don't know. Love that artwork. Here's the Incredible Hulk, $2. What else do we got in here? Plastic Man, number 16. This one's pretty cool. Secrets of Haunted House. He's alive. What is this, $5? Doctor Strange. It's pretty sweet right there. And Nick Fury, Agent of S.H.I.E.L.D. We got some cassettes. Bob Seger. What else is there? Tracy Lawrence. nothing too great. There's Elvis. Tom Petty. Pretty good. Pretty decent. Huey Lewis. That's pretty rad right there. Look at that. Love it. Heart of Rock and Roll. Randy Travis. Yes. I actually remember this Rolling Stone magazine, Jessica Simpson. I remember that. It's pretty sick. Ray Charles. And then over here, we have some comics. Oh, look at that tray. That's pretty dope. Look at that. $15. It's pretty sweet. Got some VHS and some games over here. $25 for Kinect Sports. $30 for Halo Seal, or Halo 4, but it's sealed. It's a little pricey. What do you want for $5 for Crocodile Dundee 2. It's a little high. Got some CDs, Dire Straits Creed. Can you take me higher? More Elvis, Wade Bowen, Alan Jackson, Switchfoot, Elton John, Tom Petty, and on Alabama Christmas hits. Huh. Got some plushies down here, but I saw these comics. If anything, this antique mall is filled with comics. Constantine, Animal Man, Phil Constantine, Avengers, Iron Fist. I don't really see anything that I just need or have to have. Nope. This one has some Star Wars books and some Motu. And there's also some G.I. Joe over there. Pretty sweet. And up here is a Rocket Raccoon number one, Spawn number one, Secret Wars, like She-Hulk, Master of Kung Fu, Spider-Man, yada yada yada.
And we are back from the antique mall, and unfortunately there was no pickups, but there was a lot of cool stuff to see. So this is the antique mall in Denton, Texas. If you're in the area, check it out. But we are going to get to all of the garage sale pickups, and I'm going to give you some numbers and how much I spent, so let's check it out. So first we have the PS2 console, we have the DJ Hero 2 box set, we have the Guitar Hero controller, we have the Super Soaker, we have all of the DVDs. All of that I spent a total of $38 on, so not bad at all. The PS2 by itself sells for $75. The DJ Hero 2 set sells for $25. The Guitar Hero controller can sell anywhere between $30 to $35. So I'm gonna say $30. All the DVDs totaled out to be $30 altogether. So that is a grand total of $200. And like I said, I spent $38. So not a bad day going to these garage sales at all. I recommend doing this, going to garage sales, thrift stores. I do it all the time. I tell you guys all the time, you can easily grow your collection. If you don't want the stuff, you can sell it and get the stuff that you actually want. It's very easy, and I don't know why people don't do this more often. Anyway, guys, use this information how you would like. I know some people get confused with flipping and scalping. You can't really scalp vintage items. That's kind of silly. I hear it quite a bit. But anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed it, and until next time, I will see you guys soon. Peace. Benefit.